Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today we're at my brother Mark's house, and Parker's here, and we're doing a little work on the Blair Morgan. So let's take a look and see what's going on. All right, there it is. No motor. Whoa, what happened? He blew it up. He forgot to put oil in it again. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so this is the situation. Tell him what's going on, Parker.
So basically he put his starter, or he put a starter in the slot, and I don't know if he bottomed one of the bolts out, but he broke one putting that one in. So he ran a starter with two bolts instead of three. Then the starter, the vibrations broke the other one off, and so two bolts broke off in the case. So therefore we had to take it out. We couldn't do anything about it. So there's two broken bolts, one there and one there. That's the good one right there. So we're just going to basically drill in there and try and get an easy out to pull them out.
Okay, and you have a good functioning starter. There's nothing wrong with the starter.
No, the starter's brand new.
It just wasn't. The bolts were either too long, the wrong bolt, something,
yeah,
right?
I think they were too long. I think they bottomed out.
Okay.
So I think that's why they snapped. I don't think it was tight, didn't hold it tight.
Okay. So they got the motor pulled here. And we're gonna get those bolts out. That would be the most reasonable way to do this. Otherwise, you run a risk of not having the clearance to do it properly.
There's a lot of people say you can do it in the motor and stuff, or in the slot and everything like
that.
It's
hard to get to
it. But it's really not a huge deal pulling it if you know what you're doing.
Parker does, not me.
So we just pulled this, figured it out.
Actually, Parker just got done with 2 years of schooling on this stuff.
I pulled those last year. They were actually really good.
Okay.
So we're going to go back. You show Mark your new pull start, the recoil that you ordered. Because obviously, here's the old one. A lot of issues with these.
Yeah. I replaced this 3 times last year.
Now, we did have a couple people recently mention online that there is an SPI 100% aluminum or something like that.
So
it's
this
all
is the
aluminum
part that chunked out right here that catches it.
Right.
And it just ground it to nothing. I don't know what happened or how. I don't know.
Well, they're known to
that's
go.
The new one.
Right. But that's why the guys are, from what I'm hearing, getting an SPI.
This, I don't know how this all works.
Right.
This must have been rigged up from the last guy, because it doesn't look like this one, obviously.
Right.
Because
right.
I had to replace the same part.
He probably didn't want it to explode, so he put a through bolt on there.
Yeah. Yep.
Now your new one is probably more vulnerable.
Well, the thing is, I bought all new stuff kind of like this, and the part that's supposed to hold it on didn't work, and I had to put the bolt back in.
Right. So hopefully this brand new one works good, but if you get the electric start,
I'll seldomly use it.
Right. And hopefully it's a non-issue. Okay, so here's obviously the old recoil.
Corners wore off, so it was completely slipping.
Right, and then here's the new one.
Right.
Now, we did get the recommendations for the SPI, all aluminum one, but Mark had already ordered that
before
we even got the suggestion, so.
Sorry, I was ahead of everything, and I was just moving right along.
So we're gonna roll with this. If this fails, then for sure, we will get the SPI, but we're hoping that we'll be able to just go straight up with the electric start and only have to use that on occasion or whatever.
Only when his starter breaks off again.
Yes. So let's take a look inside the sled here. Under the hood. So they're fully pulled. Yeah, we really got to get this thing working good. There's, some thought of getting another sled, but
these three bolts?
Once he gets that fixed up, we should be all right.
These three come out, then that pops out, and then that big middle one comes out, and then you have to use a clutch puller to pull that out.
Oh, okay.
So I guess
it
runs way too rich.
Yeah.
See that buildup right there?
Let's see.
See on the.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it runs way too rich.
Yeah, you gotta clean those.
I did. I cleaned them last year.
No, I know. I'm saying now. Well, you got you got to figure out why it's running so rich. That's carbon buildup.
Yep.
So, Yeah, we're going to clean this motor up. We're going to get those bolts out. And so we'll pick back up once we get a little closer to the next step.
Why don't we, we'll sell raffle tickets. $10 a ticket. We'll raffle off my sled when it's fixed.
Yeah, can't do that. It's illegal.
Did you see the sled that I got yet?
Not yet. What'd you get?
I got a Articat. Another Articat.
Uh-oh.
A 16800 RR edition.
Nice.
Yeah.
Awesome. Let's get a little further into this motor, and then we'll pick back up at that point. Here's, we've got one in cleaned and everything. Here's the second one. You can see there's a lot of oil on it. It's running rich.
Man.
Really rich.
I get it.
We can adjust that oil pump when we're in there.
Yeah, Parker's going to adjust the oil pump. Is there a lot of carbon buildup or just mostly oil?
Not much, just a little bit on the edges.
Yeah. All right.
It's just oil.
Yeah. He just cleaned them at the end of the year. So
right.
They really, the end of the year?
No.
Beginning of the year. Right. Cleaned them at the beginning of last season.
Yeah.
And that's one season of oil deposit and carbon buildup.
The pistons look really good, though. Everything looks good.
Well, that's good.
The tops have got a ton of carbon. You can see kind of in there.
Yeah. Let's go in from up top here.
Let me spin the motor over.
I'll move that lamp.
See it?
I can't really see anything in there.
That's the top of the piston and the two rings right there.
Yeah, you can see it from this side. I can see it from back here.
No, I'm saying the camera. I don't know if the camera's picking this up. I got the light on.
I was trying this light.
Yeah.
That's not helping.
You're going from the...
Yeah, it's not. You can't see.
See if we can get some light in through there. All right, there we go. Now we can see great.
There's the two rings.
Yeah.
And there's the top of the piston right there. You can see right there. It's not... There's not much scoring on the piston. There's a little bit.
It's in nice shape.
There's a little bit, but the tops of the piston have carbon buildup, which is normal.
Right. Cool.
Yeah, it's actually not that bad.
All right, so we're going to get that second rave cleaned. I actually saw you posted something on Facebook that you finally admitted you got to quit smoking.
Yeah.
You did?
He actually admitted it. That's step one.
No way, I'm hideous.
Admittance is the first step in recovery.
That's right.
I only got 9 more steps to go.
So, you know, and some of you guys realize how much Mark smokes in these videos. He's not going to like that right now. Put that away. Anyway, and believe me, we're all trying to get him to quit smoking. So,
but he's been doing this since, I mean, yours, brother, you know.
Yeah.
16 years old?
It's tough.
Yeah, 15. And he's like 75 now. So
74.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, not quite 75, but close. Anyway, dude, we got to get him to quit. Come on, give him some positive reinforcement here.
Show him my old sled.
All right, we're going to show you his old sled. Okay, so this is on his computer. That was his 2002 MXZ700.
It was old reliable after he rebuilt it twice.
Well, those rebuilds were his own fault.
The first one wasn't.
Yeah,
that was the first one, the crank went.
Well, the lower end.
Right. And then it was because he didn't put the C-clip in, and then I ran out of wood.
Right. The two top end rebuilds could have been prevented.
Started every single time, 1-2 pulls. I don't care if it was 30 degrees or minus 20. That thing was awesome.
And actually, the guy that bought this sled, I ran into him at the barber shop. I didn't know who he was, but he obviously recognized me because he knows whose sled this was. And he says, "Hey, I bought your brother's sled."
It was his dad.
Bought it for his son. And so hopefully it's still running good for him. I know it was solid when you sold
it. That was the best sled I've ever owned.
Yep.
Ever.
So, and now we just got to get this thing reliable. It's really been the recoil and the starter that have been the problems.
It ran, it was fine.
Now that it's out, we can take our time and try to get everything done right.
Exactly. So, no problem with the clutches. Mm-hmm. The shocks seem good.
You did some carb tuning last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, we changed the jets on the carbs last year. So, it was running better. Wasn't it?
Yes, a lot better.
Okay. So, with that being said, Parker just put that second rave valve back in there.
Crap up
rave.
Need some rags.
So, yeah, next onto the snapped bolts. Okay, so Parker's holding the starter here. What'd you have to say?
So we can kind of, we're just talking about length of these bolts that we need.
Right.
So we can kind of just go by.
Right, so this bolt obviously has to be much longer than that bolt.
Yeah, and vice versa.
And that bottom bolt is going to have to be the same length as the upper left bolt. So, yeah. How are the teeth on that starter? They look solid or what?
Yeah, he didn't use it much.
Let's see.
They're in real good shape. They're not.
I wonder where that little clip went.
No, they look good. So, short bolt here, short bolt down here, and then a long bolt here. So we'll have to figure out what length we need, get the right hardness. So we'll probably be, we're going to have to go buy some new bolts.
We got to get this thing ready for snow, do you?
Exactly. You going?
I'm thinking about it.
How about your dad?
My dad got his trail permit. I think he's going.
Oh, he did get the trail permit? Okay,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah,
he bought it.
Moron,
did he buy it on the 15th?
The 15th.
Okay, he did. And then,
the last
of course, Zook over here, my brother, I told him that night, Friday night at my house, hey, today's the last day to buy the, got like 5 hours to buy your trail permit at the reduced price. I'm going to buy it as soon as I get home. And then Shag did.
And I forgot.
And he forgot. Gary and I bought ours in like August. I'm just kidding, like October, literally, though. Gary and I are like, ours came in the mail the same day even. We ordered them so far in advance. We're like, you know what, we're getting it. What's the difference? So, you know, $65 isn't going to break the bank.
It's because you guys are rich.
Right.
Well, hey, you know, what are you going to do with all this freaking YouTube money? I don't know what to buy first. Parker's in college now. He's got a part-time job working with Gary. It's freaking lifting. Dude's benching. What are you benching now, Parker?
200.
No, for real.
315.
315. Nice. What do you work out with?
What do you mean?
Like, you literally do your reps with 315?
Oh, no.
Okay.
It depends on what I'm, like, how many reps, but I can do, like, 275 for four sets of four.
Nice.
Yeah. But we got to get big to throw these sleds around.
That's right.
These guys are getting old, so I got to move
on. I know, right?
Yes.
Yeah. My brother.
I mean, this is my grandpa right here.
I know.
Just like when I used to freaking hunt when I was the young nephew and everything, I was always pulling the deer around.
Yep. And you used to be able to lift some weights too.
Yeah.
Just haven't been to the gym in like 30 years.
Yeah, I used to be able to put some weight around. For my size, I was strong.
Yep. What's leaking?
Oil out of the tank.
The tank leaks?
No, we got everything disconnected.
Oh.
So it's...
So whatever you used to stop it didn't help.
Yeah.
Yep, so did you end up using the water method to pop the clutch?
Yeah.
Nice.
Tough on tape and then a little water did it.
Yeah, worked. Nice. Perfect. Scared the crap out of me when it popped, but it worked.
There you go. Okay, so let's see what we're going to do next here. I don't know, maybe... Go buy a center punch and the bolts. Okay, quiet on the set. Okay, so we have a set of three center punches. Mark, we're going to jam one of these permanently into his eyeball. And then Parker's going to use the other two to see if we can get these bolts out of the engine.
So
broken. There's two broken bolts in there.
Where the
and we bought, show them the easy outs.
Call me Vanna White.
Oh, hold on. There you go.
This is the new one.
All right, so there you go. We got a set of those. We got the center punch, and we got to extract these two broken bolts. And we got new bolts, too.
It says wear safety goggles. You better put them on.
All right.
For sure.
Safety
it's
first.
Terrible.
Safety is number one priority.
Safety third. Parker, how many eyes have you lost in your schooling?
Fortunately, none.
Okay. Did they make you wear safety glasses in class?
Allegedly, but we never wore.
Okay.
So it says use a little bit of oil when you drink.
Yeah, first we got a center punch.
Yeah, well, kind
of. You got to do one hard blow.
It's not quite centered, though.
Well, there's your problem.
better.
I'll be right back on the team.
That's good.
Is that the center?
That's better. Yeah. So for the best.
Yeah, I'm in anger.
Smaller.
We got the hole drilled in this lower hole. All right, so we got this the one out. So we drilled it with a small drill bit, and then we were able to get that out. So we got one out. We got to get the other one out here.
Punch that again.
We're using a smaller bit. Dude, it's about 3/16.
I'm going to punch Parker. What's all this punch?
Perfect.
Next week is install.
Next week? Action.
You're coming?
Yeah.
Yeah, baby. All right.
All right, let's see.
Bam.
We got her.
Got her done.
All right.
A bunch of amateurs got it out.
Right here, yeah.
YouTube mechanics is what they call it.
Yeah.
Yes. Parker's actually technically has technical training.
Right.
Where the rest of us kind of
certified, baby.
Yes. Parker's EOTC certified. And we got them both out. So now we've got the bolts. Why don't we mount the starter? Let's do that.
Because I don't know if we can get it in with the starter mounted.
Why not?
Let's just try and mount it. And we could just pull it off just to see if it'll work.
Exactly. Here's the starter.
That worked great, though.
Yeah.
All right. We actually had some success with patience. It takes patience.
Patience is a virtue.
We usually rush things, and it gets worse.
Mm-hmm. All right, what do we do with the...
We don't have to go riding tomorrow, so we didn't have to rush.
There's no snow on the ground, so we don't have to worry.
Exactly. Yeah. All the foot and a half of snow we had is gone.
Where's the other bag with the bolts? Right there.